A very good morning to all of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Respected Director Nipit, Director CRC, Dr. Shilpa, Dr. Hemant, Rajendra, and dear participants. Today we have got the privilege to do a webinar with our parent organization, Nipit. We are thankful for the opportunity. My sincere regards and gratitude to all my teachers of Nipit. Today we are because of our dear teachers. We feel blessed. So our the topic of the seminar today is e-learning and special children. Before I proceed to my talk on e-learning, I would just like to give a brief introduction to Akanksha. Akanksha is an institute. 1994 में आकांक्षा इंस्टीट्यूट बनाया गया था, जिसमें 14 बच्चे बसे थे उस टाइम पे। रायपुर में पहली संस्था थी और 25 सालों से लगातार ये अपनी सेवाएं दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों को दे रही है। और इसके अभी हाल ही में हम लोगों ने अपने 25 साल की सिल्वर जुबली को मनाने के लिए इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस किया था दिसंबर 2019 में, जिसमें बहुत अच्छा योगदान मिला था हमें। आकांक्षा के मेजर एक्टिविटीज स्पेशल स्कूल है इंटेलेक्चुअल डिसेबिलिटी के लिए, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट जहाँ पे टीचर ट्रेनिंग कोर्सेज होते हैं, डीएड स्पेशल एजुकेशन इंटेलेक्चुअल डिसेबिलिटी ऑटिज्म सीपी और वीआई पे, बीएड स्पेशल एजुकेशन होता है आईडी के लिए, रूरल बेस्ड स्कूल्स भी खुले हुए हैं, थेरेप्यूटिक सेंटर है हमारे पास में, फिजियोथेरेपी स्पीच थेरेपी ओटी रेबियल ट्रेनिंग एंड साइकोलॉजिकल सर्विसेज, वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर भी है और रीजनल लर्निंग सेंटर डेफ ब्लाइंडनेस का ईस्ट है, क्योंकि 5 राज्यों को कवर करता है, छत्तीसगढ़ वेस्ट बंगाल झारखंड उड़ीसा उत्तर प्रदेश एंड 9 स्पेशल स्कूल को विजुअली चैलेंज भी। मैं इसको इसीलिए भी बताना चाह रही हूँ क्योंकि COVID-19 और लॉकडाउन के वजह से हमारे दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों के लिए भी बहुत ज्यादा परेशानियों का सामना करना पड़ा। सडन लॉकडाउन होने के बावजूद भी लर्निंग नोज नो बाउंड, लर्निंग चैलेंजेस हैं और पॉसिबल अचीवमेंट्स भी दिखे। इस लर्निंग चैलेंजेस और पॉसिबल अचीवमेंट्स को बरकरार रखने के लिए ई लर्निंग की सहायता से हमारे शिक्षक जो स्पेशल टीचर्स हैं और अपने थेरेपिस्ट, उन लोगों ने भी जान लगाकर बहुत ही अच्छे तरीके से विद डेडिकेशन एंड डिवोशन दे हैव रेंडर्ड देयर सर्विसेज टू द पेरेंट्स। उनको सिखाया और उनको बहुत अच्छे से समझाकर अपने दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों के लिए काम करने के लिए उन्हें सहायता प्रदान की। लॉकडाउन एकदम सडन होने के वजह से स्कूल का रूटीन पूरा डिस्टर्ब हो गया, थेरेप्यूटिक सेशंस बंद हो गए, एजुकेशनल इंटरवेंशंस बंद हो गए, इसीलिए संस्थाओं को बहुत ज्यादा रोल प्ले करना पड़ रहा है ताकि बच्चों में जो फिजिकल इमोशनल बिहेवियरल प्रॉब्लम्स जो बढ़ गई थी जो घर में रहते हुए, उन लोगों को प्रशिक्षण ई लर्निंग के द्वारा करवा कर बहुत बड़ा योगदान हमारे सभी संस्थाओं में ये योगदान अपने दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों के लिए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण तरीके से दिया जा रहा है। कुछ ये ऐसे वर्कशीट बनाए गए थे टीचर्स के द्वारा, जो एक्टिविटी वर्कशीट्स के द्वारा उनको दिया गया और वो कंप्लीट करके पेरेंट्स भी उसका फोटो खींच के व्हाट्सएप में भेजा करते थे। तो इसका मतलब है कि पेरेंट्स भी बहुत ज्यादा रुचि लेकर अपने बच्चों के साथ में काम कर रहे थे। मतलब द होम ऑफ अ स्पेशल चाइल्ड हैज बिकम अ स्पेशल स्कूल एंड पेरेंट्स सिबलिंग्स एंड अदर फैमिली मेंबर्स हैव बिकम स्पेशल टीचर्स टू कैरी आउट द ड्यूटीज जुडिशियसली। तो इसका महत्व हमने एक ऐसी गतिविधि भी बनाई थी सांप सीढ़ी के जैसा, हर खंड में लगभग एक 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 डब्बे में कुछ ना कुछ गतिविधियां हैं, बच्चा इसके साथ बहुत रिक्रिएशन लीजर केयर एक्टिविटीज के द्वारा इसको खेल खेल में बहुत सारी चीजों को सीखने लग गया। सभी एक्टिविटीज हमने कराए थे, फिजिकल एक्टिविटीज, योगा, डांस, कॉन्सेप्ट थेरेपी, एवरीथिंग वाज गिवन। ये भी एक वोकेशनल का प्री वोकेशनल स्किल का डेवलपमेंट था। हमने कुछ पॉजिटिव पॉइंट्स देखे लॉकडाउन के दौरान, पेरेंट्स और फैमिली में यूनिटी दिखी, पेरेंट्स को टीचर्स के रूप में बच्चों ने स्वीकारा, क्वालिटी क्वांटिटी टाइम दिया गया, सिबलिंग बॉन्डेज दिखी, एक दूसरे के प्रति रिस्पेक्ट सम्मान दिया गया, नए नए कौशलों को सीखा, पेरेंट्स ने भी सीखा और बच्चों ने भी सीखा। म्यूचुअल सपोर्ट था, एप्रिसिएशन थे, टीम वर्क था, जिम्मेदारियों को एक दूसरे के समझ के वो लोग करने लगे। भाई बहन भी अपने बच्चों के साथ जुड़ गए। हमारे दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों को एक बहुत अच्छा माहौल घर पे मिलने लगा, ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ ई लर्निंग। वहां पर बच्चों को सेफली रहने, हाइजीनिकली रहने और सिक्योर रहने के लिए भी उनको सिखाया जाता था। और ये सब संस्था में रहकर टीचर्स और स्पेशल टीचर्स और थेरेपिस्ट ने पेरेंट्स को ट्रेन किया और पेरेंट्स इंटर्न अपने बच्चों को घर पर दिया। अब ये सब हम बात कर रहे हैं ई लर्निंग। आज हम जानेंगे कि ई लर्निंग क्या है और उसके क्या महत्व है और उसको हम किस तरीके से आगे बढ़ाना है, क्योंकि वी डोंट नो कोविड का लॉकडाउन कब तक चलेगा और हमारे बच्चे वापस अपनी संस्थाओं में कब वापस आएंगे, वी आर नॉट श्योर। लेकिन हमारा ये सिलसिला जारी रहेगा ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से। तो ई लर्निंग इज द यूज ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कंप्यूटर टेक्नोलॉजी टू क्रिएट लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंसेस। ई लर्निंग एंड स्पेशल एजुकेशन में यूज ऑफ इंटरनेट हो रहा है, वो टेक्नोलॉजिकल टूल है हमारे बच्चों के लिए, वो एजुकेशन को प्रमोट कर रहा है, वो हमारे बच्चों के लिए एक स्ट्रैटेजिक टूल डेवलप करके हमको बच्चों को उस कार्य को सरलता से करने में मदद कर रहा है। तो ई लर्निंग हमारे स्पेशल एजुकेशन बच्चों से भी ज्यादा दूर नहीं है, बच्चे बहुत अच्छे से सीख रहे हैं, लेकिन कुछ ना कुछ इसके साथ में प्रोज एंड कॉन्स भी हैं, उसको भी हम देखते हैं। नीड, आवश्यकता क्यों पड़ गई है ई लर्निंग, क्योंकि देखिए अभी शिक्षा का द एजुकेशन पैटर्न्स आर चेंजिंग। इंटरनेट इज नाउ चेंजिंग द एजुकेशनल मोडालिटीज, ट्रेडिशनल क्लासरूम्स बदल रहे हैं और हमारे बच्चों को ई लर्निंग को अगर ध्यान देना है तो उनकी उम्र, उनका टाइप, उनका लेवल ऑफ इम्पेयरमेंट को ध्यान देते हुए ई लर्निंग को प्रमोट करना है। प्रिपेयर अवर स्पेशल चिल्ड्रेन यूज ई लर्निंग कोर्सेस, जो भी होगा वो वोकेशनल स्किल बेस्ड हो और जॉब ओरिएंटेड हो। कंसिडरेशंस, हम जब ई लर्निंग करते हैं तो उसमें कुछ ना कुछ कंसिडरेशंस रखना जरूरी है। सबसे पहले हमारा लर्नर, लर्नर चाहे किसी भी दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित हो, उसको प्राथमिकता देते हुए उसके लिए लर्निंग मटेरियल तैयार करें, उसके लिए सुदृढ़ लर्निंग वातावरण तैयार करें ताकि बच्चा उस माहौल में अच्छे तरीके से सीख सके। रहा सवाल टेक्नोलॉजी का, असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी भी है बच्चों के लिए यूज करने लायक और साथ में अपना ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से भी कई प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं जिसकी सहायता से हमारे बच्चों को हम सिखा सकेंगे। बच्चों के लिए ई लर्निंग कन्वीनियंट रहेगा, फ्लेक्सिबल रहेगा, वो कभी भी घर में रह के कोई भी समय पर वो हम बच्चों को सिखा सकते हैं। हम ज्यादा ध्यान देंगे उनके लर्निंग पैटर्न्स पे। उनको टीचर्स को भी हमको टेक्नो फ्रेंडली बनाना आवश्यकता हो गई है, क्योंकि जब तक टीचर्स टेक्नो फ्रेंडली नहीं है तो वो अपने बच्चों को कैसे सिखा सकते। तो टीचर्स आर ऑल्सो लर्निंग टू बिकम टेक्नो फ्रेंडली, एंड क्लासरूम का सदुपयोग करना बहुत जरूरी हो गया। जब एक स्क्रीन पे, अगर हम व्हाट्सएप की वीडियो स्क्रीन पे अगर डांस टीचर आ रहा है और डांस सिखा रहा है बच्चों को, बच्चे उस समय पर देखकर उसे एकदम क्लोजनेस होगी और वो अपना बच्चे टीचर्स को देखकर वो भी काम को करने लग जाएंगे। इससे हम क्या कर रहे हैं कि सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग भी मेंटेन कर रहे हैं जो कोविड की आवश्यकता है, और हम सोशलाइजेशन को भी बरकरार रख रहे हैं कि बच्चे परिचित चेहरे दिखाते हुए उनको सिखाने का एक माहौल प्रदान कर रहे हैं। करिकुलम इवैल्यूएशन पैटर्न्स को चेंज करना पड़ेगा ई लर्निंग में, और पेरेंट्स का इन्वॉल्वमेंट और ट्रेनिंग और घर का वातावरण ये बहुत ज्यादा मुख्य हो गया है, क्योंकि पेरेंट्स हमारे अभी टीचर्स बन गए हैं घर पर। तो पेरेंट्स को सिखा रहे हैं हमारे स्पेशल टीचर्स और बच्चों को घर पे सिखा रहे हैं उनके खुद के माँ बाप, उनके भाई बहन, दादा दादी, नाना नानी, बुआ चाचा, ये सब लोग मिलके हमारे बच्चों को बहुत अच्छा एक माहौल दे रहे हैं। रहा सवाल होम एनवायरनमेंट का, पूरे घर को हम स्पेशल स्कूल तो नहीं बना सकते, तो एक कॉर्नर को निर्धारित करें, एक जगह को निर्धारित करें जहाँ बच्चे को लेकर कि अब मैं स्कूल जा रहा हूँ तो मेरे घर का ये कोना मुझे पढ़ाई लिखाई के लिए है और ये कोना मेरे खेलने के लिए है। तो इस तरीके से हम एक डिसिप्लिन डेवलप करेंगे अपने बच्चों के लिए। ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस में कैसा प्रभाव पड़ रहा है, इट इज इम्प्रूविंग द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ लर्निंग, it is increasing the motivational level of the learners, it is making the child understand the concepts to the deeper meaning, new approaches of learning ho raha, new ways of interaction ho raha, interest in learning, vibhinn prakar ki gativithiyon se bachcha khush hota hai seekhne ke liye, इट इज इम्प्रूविंग सेल्फ इवेल्युएशन, वाइडर रीच एंड कंसिस्टेंसी, फ्लेक्सिबल तरीका हो रहा है, डिफरेंट लर्निंग मोड्स हैं, डिफरेंट लर्निंग स्टाइल्स हैं, सेल्फ पेसिंग, अपने ही समय पर बच्चा, जब भी बच्चा तैयार है सीखने के लिए तब दिया जा रहा है, उसमें कोई पाबंदी नहीं लगाई जा रही है, कोई उसको प्रेशर नहीं दे रहा है, कोई फोर्स नहीं कर रहा है, उसका सेटिस्फेक्शन लेवल इंक्रीज हो रहा है और पूरा ओवरऑल पर्सनालिटी डेवलपमेंट में भी चेंजेस दिखाई दे रहे हैं इस ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से। ई लर्निंग को अगर हमको एक कल्चर डेवलप करना है तो ये तीन बिंदुओं को बहुत ध्यान से देखना है और समझना है, लर्नर है, टीचर्स हैं और एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। खास तौर पे हम एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन पे चलते हैं क्योंकि अगर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में हमारा अगर इंस्टीट्यूट ही ई लर्निंग के एनवायरनमेंट कल्चर को अगर डेवलप नहीं करता, रिसोर्सेस को डेवलप नहीं करता, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को प्रोवाइड नहीं करता आईसीटी को, तब हम अपने ना तो टीचर्स को ट्रेन कर पाएंगे ना तो हम बच्चों तक के पहुंच पाएंगे। तो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, चाहे वो इंस्टीट्यूट हो, स्कूल हो या कोई भी संस्था हो, उसको इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर आईसीटी के लिए और ई लर्निंग के लिए स्थापित करना होगा। दूसरा होता है हमारे टीचर्स डेवलप करेंगे स्किल को और लर्निंग स्किल्स को डेवलप करने से बच्चों तक के पहुंचते हैं, जहां बच्चे अपने सेल्फ डायरेक्टेड, सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड और सेल्फ रेगुलेटेड रहते हैं। और बच्चों को भी सिखाना होगा कि ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से किस तरीके से वो नया नया सीख सकेंगे। देन ई लर्निंग के कुछ टूल्स हैं जिसके माध्यम से हम उन लोगों को सिखा सकते हैं, जैसे ई मेल्स है, वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग है, टेली कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग है, लर्निंग मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, पॉडकास्ट है, चैट्स है, फोरम है, विकिपीडिया है, वेब पेजेस है, और टॉप ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म्स भी कुछ हैं जो कि शायद राजेंद्र आपको और डिटेल में बताएंगे। पाठशाला है, नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी है, स्वयं प्रभा है, और इस तरीके के जो ई लर्निंग टूल्स के माध्यम से हमारे दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों को हम घर पहुंच शिक्षा प्रदान कर सक रहे हैं। बेनिफिट्स क्या है इसके? फोकसेस ऑन नीड्स ऑफ लर्नर्स, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी है, इफेक्टिव यूज ऑफ टाइम हो रहा है, ट्रैवल एक्सपेंसेस को हम कट डाउन कर रहे हैं, होम बेस्ड ट्रेनिंग हो रही है, इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड लर्निंग हो रही है, लर्निंग कंटेंट स्मॉलर यूनिट्स में दिया जा रहा है, लेस इंटिमिडेटिंग, ज्यादा प्रभाव और ज्यादा प्रेशर नहीं दिया जा रहा है, क्विक लर्निंग लेसन हो रहे हैं, वर्ल्ड वाइड लर्निंग सोसाइटी, नो रेस्ट्रिक्शन, एंड देन कन्वीनियंट है, सेल्फ लर्निंग है, मिक्स एंड मैच, कभी ऑडियो के साथ में दे रहे हैं तो कभी वीडियो के साथ दे रहे हैं या दोनों को साथ में देख के बच्चों को सिखाया जा रहा है, सेल्फ पेस्ड है, रिपीटेबल है, एंड बहुत सारे एडवांटेजेस हमारे ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से बच्चों को सिखा सकेंगे। लेकिन कुछ बाधाएं भी हैं। ये बाधाएं हैं, ई कंटेंट, ई मटेरियल और ई प्लेटफॉर्म अभी उतना ज्यादा डेवलप नहीं है क्योंकि ये एक अचानक आ गया कोविड के वजह से। अब हमको ई लर्निंग, ई कंटेंट, ई प्लेटफॉर्म पर ज्यादा ध्यान देना होगा। ऑनलाइन टीचिंग के लिए ऑनलाइन क्लासेस और सोशल इमोशनल बॉन्डिंग जो डेवलप होता है टीचर्स और बच्चों के बीच में, वो जरूर नहीं दिखेगा, लेकिन हम कोशिश करेंगे कि बच्चों के साथ में जुड़े रहे, फेस टू फेस लर्निंग भी बहुत ज्यादा। लर्नर्स, टीचर्स फुली इक्विप्ड ई लर्निंग के हमारे पास में साधन नहीं है, लेकिन उसको डेवलप करना है। रूरल और रिमोट एरियाज में तो बहुत ज्यादा अवेयरनेस की कमी है, उस अवेयरनेस को हमको डेवलप करना है रूरल और रिमोट एरियाज। कई बार कनेक्टिविटी का प्रॉब्लम आता है, पुअर या नो कनेक्टिविटी रहती है रूरल एरियाज में, अर्बन एरियाज में भी रहती है, और कई बार एक्सेसिबिलिटी नहीं रहती है, हम रिसोर्स मटीरियल को लेना डाउनलोड करना चाहते हैं वो नहीं हो पाता है, कई बार हम बहुत डिपेंडेंट हो जाते हैं ओवरसीज, जैसे वेस्टर्न में जितने लिटरेचर या रिसोर्सेज डेवलप हैं हम उसी के ऊपर में डिपेंड रहते हैं, जो कि हिंदी लैंग्वेज में या हमारे इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस में अवेलेबल नहीं है। तो इसके लिए भी सोच करके हमको इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस में ऐसे रिसोर्सेज डेवलप करना है ताकि हमारे बच्चे उसका लाभ उठा सके। कई बार आईसीटी बहुत अनएफोर्डेबल प्राइसेस पे रहता है, बहुत कम लोग उसको खरीद सकते हैं और बहुत कम लोग उसका फायदा ले रहे हैं। तो मूलतः हम अगर देखें तो ई लर्निंग कैन बी यूज एज अ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री बट नॉट एज सप्लीमेंट्री, लेकिन बहुत कुछ हम ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से हम अपने बच्चों को मदद पहुंचा सकेंगे। जी हमारे हाथ में या तो कंप्यूटर्स के माध्यम में या लैपटॉप या फोन या टैबलेट्स में हम लगातार इसका उपयोग कर रहे हैं, और ई लर्निंग और टेक्नोलॉजी वाइडर अवेलेबल है, प्रेफर्ड वे ऑफ लर्निंग है, और वो हमको पूरा उस कार्य को करने के लिए एकदम ध्यान पैदा करता है। असिस्टिव डिवाइसेस हमारे WHO के CBR के गाइडलाइंस में भी बहुत महत्व दिया गया है कि वो इस तरीके से बने ताकि हमारे अडेप्ट किए जाएं, ताकि हमारे बच्चे जो दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित हैं आसानी से उसका लाभ उठा सकें। And areas in which assistive technology can help is education, mobility, employment, leisure and recreation, communication and socialization. कुछ e-learning और e-technology के वजह से, जैसे आपको example के तौर पे dragon dictation है, यहाँ पे एक CP से ग्रसित बच्ची है cerebral palsy से, और ये अपना टाइप नहीं कर पा रही है, तो वो मुंह से बोलेगी तो वो खुद अपने आप टाइप होगा, तो वो आत्मनिर्भर हो जाएगी ड्रैगन डिक्टेशन का उपयोग करके। तो ये एक असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी है। इसी तरीके से असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी हमारे विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड के लिए भी है, बुक्स ऑन टेप, आई ग्लासेस हैं, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मैग्नीफायर्स हैं, ब्रेल मटेरियल्स हैं, ब्रेल एंड स्पीक। जब वो विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड पर्सन जब वो बोलता है तो वो ब्रेल में टाइप हो जाता है। कई बार रीडिंग पेन्स हैं, वो पेन को उस लिखावट पे रखेगा तो वो पढ़ के सुनाएगा कि क्या लिखा हुआ है। तो ये सब टेक्नोलॉजी है, असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी। फिंगर रीडर है, हाथ पे जब हम लाइन पे उंगली चलाते जाएंगे तो वो पढ़ के सुनाते जाएगा कि क्या लिखा हुआ है उसमें। सो दीज आर द लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज विच आर बींग यूज इन द वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज, बट वी हैव टू अडेप्ट एंड मेक सच। हमारे इंजीनियर्स, हमारे टेक्नोलॉजी से जो जुड़े हुए व्यक्ति हैं, उन लोगों को हमको प्रेरित करना चाहिए कि ऐसी टेक्नोलॉजी इंडिया में भी ले आए और इंडिया में हमारे दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चों के लिए बहुत ज्यादा लाभदायक और उपयोगी बनाए। लो विजन डिवाइस है ये, जहाँ पर वो मैग्निफाई हो गया है जो वो पढ़ना चाह रही है तो आसानी से वो पढ़ सकेंगे। देन टॉकिट है ये, इट इज एन इनोवेटिव एप्लीकेशन टू हेल्प पीपल विद स्पीच एंड लैंग्वेज डिसऑर्डर्स टू कम्युनिकेट विद समवन एल्स। इट विल ट्रांसलेट अनइंटेलिजिबल प्रोनंसिएशन इनटू अंडरस्टैंडेबल स्पीच सो दैट वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दे मेंट टू से डिस्पाइट द स्पीच इंपेडिमेंट। सीखे कितना अच्छा अच्छा टेक्नोलॉजी असिस्टिव डेवलप हो रहा है और हो चुका है, और इसका उपयोग करने से हमारे बच्चे का कितना भला होगा, कितना अच्छे से वो ज्ञान ज्ञान से ले सकेंगे। ये हमारे ऑटिस्टिक बच्चों के लिए भी है कुछ ना कुछ, और लर्निंग डिसेबिलिटी वाले बच्चों के लिए भी उपयोगी रिसोर्स मटेरियल्स हैं। माउथ स्टिक है ये हमारे अगेन सेरेब्रल पाल्सी वाले बच्चों के लिए, हेडबैंड है जिसका उपयोग करके वो इस काम को इस शिक्षा को ग्रहण कर रहे हैं। ये ऑटोमोबाइल्स में भी देखिए कि कितने आत्मनिर्भर हो जाते हैं हमारे फिजिकली इम्पेयर्ड पर्सन भी। इन लोगों के लिए खुद गाड़ी चलाना बहुत सरल हो गया क्योंकि उनका पूरा गाड़ी मॉडिफाई हो गया, उनका व्हीलचेयर ही खुद अंदर चला जाता है गाड़ी में, और वो आराम से आत्मनिर्भर होकर अपने कार्य शरीर को कर रहे हैं। टेक्नोलॉजी एंड स्पोर्ट्स में भी देखा गया है कि कितना ज्यादा चेंजेस आई है टेक्नोलॉजी की वजह से। ये सब पूरा ई लर्निंग का ही एक देन है जिसके वजह से आज हम दिव्यांगता से ग्रसित बच्चे भी सामान्य बच्चों को के साथ में आराम से हम उनको भी उनके समान ही अपने इस फील्ड को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं और हर क्षेत्र में उनकी भागीदारी देखी जा रही है। अंत में मैं ये कहूंगी कि ये कुछ रिकमेंडेशन है ई लर्निंग और स्पेशल एजुकेशन पे, हमको डेवलप करना होगा एक ई लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट। बार बार मैं कहूंगी ई लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट से मेरा तात्पर्य है इंस्टीट्यूट को, स्पेशल स्कूल को वैसा एक वातावरण बनाना होगा ताकि हमारे बच्चों को ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से वो उनको शिक्षा प्रदान कर सकेंगे। प्रिपेयर अवर स्पेशल चिल्ड्रेन फॉर ई लर्निंग, हमारे स्पेशल चिल्ड्रेन को भी ई लर्निंग के लिए तैयार करने के लिए प्रशिक्षण दिया जाना चाहिए। ट्रेन अवर स्पेशल टीचर्स टू रेंडर ई लर्निंग, यस हमारे स्पेशल टीचर्स अगर ट्रेन है ई लर्निंग को हैंडल करने के लिए तभी वो हमारे बच्चों को भी मदद कर सकेंगे। एक्सेस टू ऑल ई लर्निंग, चाहे वो लोकेशन ग्रामीण क्षेत्र हो, शहरी क्षेत्र हो, या रूरल क्षेत्र हो, या रिमोट प्लेस हो, वहां पे सब ई लर्निंग के लिए एक्सेस होने के लिए कंप्यूटर्स का, वाईफाई सिस्टम, इंटरनेट सिस्टम बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे से एक्सेस होने पर ही हम दूर दूर तक हमारे बच्चों तक के हम पहुंच सकेंगे। अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ ई लर्निंग इक्विपमेंट एंड असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी, यस हमको सरकार से भी निवेदन करना होगा कि असिस्टिव टेक्नोलॉजी हमारे बच्चों तक के मिले और वो उसका सदुपयोग कर सके। कोर्स कंटेंट और करिकुलम इस तरीके से डिजाइन करें ताकि बच्चे के नीड बेस्ड हो और बच्चे के लेवल ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी और प्रकार टाइप ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी के आधार पर हम ई लर्निंग को स्थापित करें और ई लर्निंग के माध्यम से हम उनको मदद पहुंचा सकें। पेरेंट ट्रेनिंग एंड ई लर्निंग, पेरेंट्स का रहना बहुत जरूरी है क्योंकि मैं तो मानूंगी एक ट्रायंगल बनता है, जब बच्चा हमारा ट्रायंगल के एपेक्स पे है तो एक कोने पे पेरेंट है तो एक कोने पे हमारा स्कूल है, तो ये तीनों का सामंजस्य होना बहुत जरूरी है। कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड कोऑपरेशन विद द पेरेंट्स एंड द टीचर्स विल डेफिनेटली बेनिफिट अवर चिल्ड्रन। तो ये पेरेंट्स को भी हमको ट्रेन करना होगा कि ई लर्निंग को किस तरीके से लर्न करें। अभी पेरेंट्स सीमित हैं, व्हाट्सएप तक के वो बहुत अच्छे से जानकारियां प्रदान कर रहे हैं और ले रहे हैं, और उन लोग पेरेंट्स अपना रुझान भी दिखा रहे हैं कि अपने बच्चों को किस तरीके से हम उनको घर बैठे शिक्षा प्रदान करें। उनके घर के वातावरण को भी हमें कुछ ना कुछ परिवर्तन लाना होगा क्योंकि बच्चों को ऐसा नहीं लगना चाहिए कि घर भी स्कूल बन गया है और हमको कुछ समय के बाद स्कूल में जाना पड़ेगा, तो वो अलग से स्कूल और घर एक स्कूल। तो ये इसके लिए हमको होम एनवायरनमेंट में भी एक अलग से कमरा निर्धारण कर देना चाहिए ताकि बच्चों को लगना चाहिए कि हाँ मुझे यहाँ पर पढ़ाई कराई जाएगी और मैं ये वाले हिस्से पे मुझे चाहे मैं रिक्रिएशन रूम है, टीवी रूम है, प्ले रूम है या बैठक रूम है, जो भी हो, तो बच्चे भी इस तरीके से डिसिप्लिन हो जाएंगे और बहुत अच्छे से इसको सीख पाएंगे। सो आई एंड माई लेक्चर विद दिस। थैंक यू सो मच। एनी क्वेश्चंस, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम।
थैंक यू, थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम फॉर योर ग्रेट सजेशन एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट विल बी हेल्पफुल टू द प्रोफेशनल्स हु आर वर्किंग इन द फील्ड ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी रिहैबिलिटेशन नाउ. हेलो, थैंक यू, थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू. सो नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर हेमंत सिंह केसवाल सर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर स्पेशल एजुकेशन, निपेड रीजनल सेंटर नोएडा, to talk about e-learning and its implication to the person with intellectual disability, how it will be helpful. Dr. Hemant Singh Kespal. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So, good morning, all of you. Dear speakers, Dr. Simmi Srivastava, Director NIPED, Deputy Director NIPED, and my co-speaker, Mr. Rajendra Praveen, and dear participants. Today, I have got an opportunity to speak on the role of e-learning for education of children with intellectual disability. Although it's a very interesting topic, as it has been said that necessity is an invention, mother of invention, and definitely when we talk of in e-learning for PWDs, it was a distant dream before lockdown. In fact, COVID-19 has promoted e-learning to the maximum extent. In fact, we have not heard much about webinars or classes through distance online mode or teaching children e-learning of children with special needs. There used to be huge projects going on in pipe, were in process, but nothing could materialize. But this lockdown of about 2 months have definitely helped us to bring together and come up with this new solution of e-learning, and it has helped to a great extent, and not only to children with intellectual disabilities, but also it has helped other people. People do say that COVID has stopped our life, but I perceive it as an opportunity. It's wonderful that although we are not able to meet each other, meet face to face, eat at each other, but through this online mode, we have been interacting quite frequently. We have not been attending so many seminars in a year, but over the past 2 months, I believe we had attended more than 15 to 20 webinars. So it has been a good platform, in fact, and this is basically through e-learning mode itself only that we are in a position to interact with each other, discuss professional things, personal things, and get to know and enhance our knowledge. So a lot of things are taken care of amidst this pandemic. But yes, pandemic is definitely a serious thing, but we have come up with a solution of e-learning, and let's discuss how it can help e-learning can help children with intellectual disabilities to enhance their learning. And I would also highlight on the issues how we can strengthen it, because definitely we were not prepared for this. As my previous speaker said, it was a sudden shock, and we need to come up with a solution, and with the solution had to a certain extent worked up very well. So at the onset, I would like to put up the definition of e-learning, which have been put forward by various experts. It includes all e-learning includes all kind of utilization of ICT in instructions. And second definition, of some experts do believe that it is limited to use of intranet and internet in teaching learning process. And these are the benefits of e-learning. Self-service, mix and match you can do, then whatever you can, resources you can take out from the net and your computer, you can share it on demand, anytime, anywhere you can start teaching. Private learning is possible, then self-paced, whatever the pace of learner is, accordingly they can manage it. The flexibility is there on, you can divide the learning packages into modular packages, and they can be taught as per the needs of the learners. Learner here, we are focusing specifically on intellectual disability. And media rich, easier to understand, more engaging, repeatable, you can repeat it more than one, and easier to monitor the progress. You can evaluate, self-evaluate. So for teachers also, it's good, pretty good. And for the learner also, he or she can evaluate whatever he has learned. Then these are various e-learning tools, video conferencing, then various websites, online forum, audio chats, and scope of emails. So through these various e-learning tools, we can interact each other through online modes. Then virtual classroom. Before, I would like to highlight something on virtual classroom, because how we go ahead. So definitely virtual classrooms are the necessity, because it's going to, since pandemic, this pandemic is not going to be over in the near future. So we need to look forward for certain solutions. So virtual classroom is could be one of the solution, where virtual classrooms are not a new concept, but yes, smart boards, whiteboards, SWAM, MOOC, massive open online courses, platforms, Skype, WhatsApp, Zoom, IPO members, rooms, and many other audio visual platforms are available to explore. And these are certain e-resources for I have mentioned, which is here you can see children with autism and intellectual disabilities, and various platforms where you can use them as the virtual classrooms, as well as some educational apps are also available on this Best ABC Games for Kids. Then requirements of this is the requirement which we should have for virtual classroom. Ensure that the parents and teachers have access to internet and backup power. Parents and teachers must have access to laptop or PCs or small or smartphone with not less than 5-inch screen should be there. Children must preferably use laptop or PCs. Please avoid mobile as much as possible, so that the display can be wider and they can learn it better. Download Skype or WhatsApp MOOC on computer or phone. then make small groups of children based on the age or the grouping as per the grouping norms of various disability. We have different norms for grouping. Then pre-plan the individual or group activity so that accordingly we can put up develop a lesson plan and teach develop teaching learning methodology and put up a good lesson plan for teaching. Then video conferencing versus virtual classroom. There have been certain people are often overlapping this terminology. So I thought it would be an appropriate forum to discuss that what is video conferencing and what is virtual classroom platform. So video conferencing platforms like WhatsApp or Skype and virtual classroom platforms like Swayam, MOOC and other platforms. Video conferencing platforms include very generic application for communication purposes, and whereas the virtual classroom are specifically designed to build to provide classroom experience on virtual platform. Video conference does not have ability to define and organize contents as per pedagogy, curriculum and learning outcomes. Whereas virtual classroom pedagogy or curriculum and learning outcomes can be defined and organized for systematic learning. In video conferencing does not have provisions of for this repository to restore and share document and knowledge points during the course of learning. Whereas in virtual classroom generally has repository to store and share documents and knowledge points. Video conferencing does not have assessment and measures to track and monitor learning outcome. Whereas where virtual classroom provides feedback mechanism in form of measures to track and monitor learning and assessment. These are learning challenges for persons with intellectual disability. We often see that they have problems in memory, concentration, attention, reading skills, writing skills, mathematics, communication skills, and they have limited logical thinking and reasoning abilities. So how do we addressing these barriers? There are four kind of time barrier, space barrier, analog digital barrier, and norm barrier. So e-learning can be used by learners to allot their time to learn when they want to learn, can also travel back and forth in time, making it possible to examine the pace of learning and accordingly make necessary accommodations as per the learning ability of or severity of person with intellectual disability. The pace can be modified. Then space barrier. In e-learning, learning objects can be distributed all over the world, made accessible to learners via internet. It allows learners to access rare resources and expand their learning space. Sky is the limit, what we say when we talk of e-learning, because everything is nowadays available on Google or internet, and whatever learners want to learn, they can take cross references, or they can also enhance their develop their learning as per their requirements. They can learn. Analog digital barrier. Digital content offers a possibility to combine different media such as video, audio, text, and images. This enables learners to interact with digital content using different digital media for their learning process more easily than analog media. This enhances learning and develop interest in amongst persons with intellectual disabilities also. So it is in conventional learning, if you see, there we don't have so many modes of learning. Here we can mix and match the audio, video, text and images, so that we can make the learning more interesting and children can learn it better. They can retain the learning in a better way. So all kinds of learn, you can make the children learn various concepts in multiple ways with the analog digital barrier. Then norm barrier. Norm barrier can be overcome by e-learning, resulting in growth of learning opportunities for all people. E-learning provides more individualized and personalized learning. This is very important for children with disabilities, where personalized and individualized learning is very important. We need to plan the learner-centric approach, adopt learner-centric approach, and plan the lesson plans according to the needs of a particular individual. So it's very nice in that sense. For person with intellectual disability, it can be expanded. It can expand the scope of learning opportunities, accessible content for learning, accessible communication between all learners, and accessible construction of person as well as shared knowledge can lead to expanded learning opportunities for persons with intellectual disabilities. Technology and e-learning. Speakable items like speech synthesis, voice recognition, etc. Portable word processors, these are some of the technological gadgets and e-learning which helps in e-learning. Alternate keyboards like one hand keyboard or little finger keyboards, mouse alternatives like scroll wheels, trackball or head mouse, touch screen or windows, touch windows, word prediction software. So this helps in e-learning. Then accessible e-learning technology, principles of accessible content that is perceivable, operable, understandable and robust. These are four principles which we will be discussing now. Perceivable provide text alternatives for any non-text content, example large print, braille, speech symbols or simpler language. Provide synchronized alternative for media, multimedia. Recreate content that can be presented in different ways, spoken aloud, simpler layout, etc. Make it easier for person with intellectual disability to see and hear content, including separating foreground from background. This is something very important when children having some kind of learning disabilities get confused with foreground and background things. So how we can highlight the foreground, this can be very important. Then operable, make all functionality available from keyboard, provide users with disability enough time to read and use content. Do not create content that is known to cause seizures. Provide ways to help the users.
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, Dr. Shimi. That was a nice presentation.
Okay.
I have a question regarding, like, now that the e-learning has come up so much because of the COVID-19, there is also a fear from the parents that the children are getting addicted to the mobile phone, even though it is for learning for some times. So what can we do about children not getting addicted?
That's a very nice question, Dr. Shilpa, because even we have faced such kind of problems from our parents' side. So we have been telling to the parents that, hey, you have to maintain a timetable at home also. That's what I was telling in my presentation also. All the time we cannot be giving them the training on the internet or on the laptops or on the telephones or on the mobile. So it can be outside the these gadgets also the learning can take place. So it is better that we have to mix and match and use the techniques to teach the children at home. Because many a times children will definitely demand of use of mobile phones constantly. So here we have to use our behavior management principles also, where we can coax them or we can reinforce them or reward them when they are not using or when they are listening to us, we can reward them So in this way, I think we will be able to make the child learn that whenever it is a necessity, then only it will be given to them and at an appropriate time and schedule. So that the child is also learning the disciplinary action which is taking place in the house. So all the time the telephones and mobiles are not available to the children. This has to be conveyed to the children in a very nice manner without reprimanding or without punishment. So I think we have to counsel the parents how to take care of handling the mobile phones and the internet facility at home depending upon the need, and also time-based and fixed timings should be given. Then only I think it will be more helpful for the child to learn. Is it, as I answered the questions of Shilpa?
Yes, Dr. Shimi, definitely. I think it's very important that the parents stick to a particular routine and fix the timings. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I'm constantly answering the questions which are coming into the question and answer box. So,
ma'am, I have two questions.
Yeah.
One is that when you're dealing with children with hyperactivity, younger children especially, how do we hold their attention, especially because the parents are sitting there and, you know, if the parent moves away, the child tends to move away. And the second question is the continuous interference of the parent when the class is going on, as in, you know, that when we are trying to get an answer from the child, that the parent is continuously goading the child, answer it, or they are reading it out to the child. So how do we do that?
So, according to the question, I don't think so. The child is hyperactive. The parent is hyperactive. The parent has to have to develop patience. They have to give that pace for the child to reply. So, parents need not be very, very, they should not pressurize the child to give an answer. They should rather coax and rather help the child to come out with the correct answer rather than forcing them to come out with the answer. So hyperactivity, the definition itself tells that they don't sit in one place for a fraction of a second also, or even for half a minute also. So if that is the condition, then we have to definitely, we give them some physical, we are physically stopping the child to do an activity and hold the child tightly for some time. Not very tightly that it is going to hurt, but you can do that and then make the try to get the eye-to-eye contact with the child, and then only you can continue your whatever activity you want to do. Once the child is having an eye-to-eye contact with you, then only he will be able to respond it in a very positive manner. Okay?
All right, ma'am. Thank you.
Paswan ji, you can ask your question.
Hello, Jit.
Hello.
हाँ बात कीजिए.
Yes, sir.
हाँ.
हाँ बात. मदर टंग होते हैं, एज 2 इयर्स, 6 इयर्स, बच्चों के लिए हम क्या डिसाइड कर सकते हैं?
आपका आवाज क्लियर नहीं है, प्लीज रिपीट द क्वेश्चन.
ओके मैम, ये जो एज एज से 10 इयर्स के बीच जो एक्टिविटी डिसाइड करना मैम.
बेटा आपका आवाज ब्रेक हो रहा है, मैं कुछ समझ नहीं पा रही हूँ. बस 10 साल सुनाई में दिया मुझे, 10 इयर्स. व्हाट
यस मनोज,
कैन यू पुट दैट क्वेश्चन इन द क्वेश्चन आंसर बॉक्स, आई विल आंसर इट.
ओके मैम. ओके
glitch, but someone has connected through more than 2 devices in the same room, and because of that there is a very much of audio disturbance. I would request the participants who have connected from more than 1 device to please disconnect from one of your devices. It is going to affect the entire presentation. So kindly please disconnect from the other device. There is an echo because of that. Thank you so much. While we try to resume our rest of the presenters, we would continue our question and answers with Dr. Shimi. Dr. Shimi, there is a question regarding the teaching of co-curricular activities. Can you please expand a little more on how can we take up co-curricular activities through e-learning? Because academic activities, you know, is somehow people are aware of to teach with. But when it comes to co-curricular activities like dance, drama, or music, or any other fun activity, it's a little difficult to plan. Can you just share your views on how can teachers plan things, especially for children with our intellectual and other developmental disabilities?
Definitely, Shilpa, because during this 2 months lockdown, even at Akanksha, our special teachers have taken really great pains in developing and creating videos. They have made videos of dance, yoga, and extracurricular activities like cooking, making tea. The special educators have themselves done this, and their family members have recorded that. And they have sent this video records and video clippings to the parents. And parents, they are familiar with the WhatsApp. They can open up the videos and they see the videos and then they learn how to do it. So this is what we have been doing with. And we have got a tremendous good response from the parents. Also in the rural areas, our special educators have developed certain video clippings, audio clippings, so that the parents feel more comfortable in opening up, and then they themselves learn that activity first, and then they turn teach the children at home. So this has given us a very strong base. The videos have given us a strong base in developing or creating co-curricular activities for the parents to learn, and in turn they will learn. And surprisingly, the fathers have also shown so much interest in taking and teaching our special children, especially the intellectually disabled children at home, that they have also taught the children at home, and they took a video of their teaching, how the parent is teaching the child at home. They took that video and they sent in turn to us, okay, this is what we have done. So this kind of exchange of videos have definitely shown that the parents have become, they are interested in teaching the children at home, and they have become special teachers at home. So this gave us a very big satisfaction to us. Yes, we are able to help our children through making parents competent enough through videos and audios, and even telephonic conversations were also made by the teachers, especially teachers and the therapists, which has definitely shown a good improvement in the children, because we also wanted to see the evaluation patterns. So we also made an evaluation sheet. Okay, these are the things to be entered. And we made these sheets and sent as images to the parents, and parents were able to do it. So I think we have to be more creative enough in making the parents teach how to teach the children at home. And ek aur mazay ki baat ye thi ki parents apne ghar ke resources, they were using the resources which were available at home. Like teaching learning material is not there at home, but sabjiyon ko pura le aaye aur sabjiyon ko chhatna, matching, identification, naming, everything the parents were doing at home. They gave the things in front of the children, and the parents literally gave them prompting, physical prompting, gestures, visual, all those clues were given to the parents. And the mother is teaching the child, and father took out the video and he sent the video to us. So this shows the interest of the parent. The matlab they want definitely to help the parents at the children at home. So this we have done, and we have seen success in this kind of interchange activities through WhatsApp videos and WhatsApp audio methods. Did I answer the question, Shilpa?
Yeah, thank you so much. That was really, I think I have to really congratulate all the parents who have really, you know, stepped into and were trying
We can share the videos with you, Shilpa. The parents, they have really made wonderful videos. Yes, and yes, our teachers have also made so wonderful videos on dance, yoga, making tea and then serving tea, and then making sandwiches, everything, all the curricular, extracurricular, co-curricular activities are made videos and audios, and then telephonic conversations. So these three modes we have utilized.
I think we need to really give a big hand for all the parents and teachers during this crisis time. And let me move to one more question, which I find very interesting in the Q&A box. That is regarding the mobile games. I'm sure you will agree to me that not only children who are typically developing, normally developing, but even children with autism and other developmental disabilities are somehow very keen on playing a lot of mobile games, and that too educational games. There are quite a lot of educational games on so many apps nowadays. So how do you find these games especially useful for our children with intellectual and developmental disabilities?
Again, I will tell you, there should be limit to everything. Games are not bad, because they are also educating the child to do, learn an activity. But only thing is that we have to stick to the time limits. So we have to stick to the time limits. We have to tell them, yes, that not more than 10 minutes you have to play this game. Okay, the child will also understand that 10 minutes means 10 minutes. You should not prolong the 11th minute also. Then only the child will give respect to that 10 minutes and do that activity. And then we have also to reinforce the child after doing his 10 minutes activity. So I think that video games are not going to be harmful if we stick to the time limits and disciplining the child simultaneously. So whatever is there, e-learning ke madhyam se definitely children are going to learn, but we have to plan and be very, sometimes we have to be flexible also. So in this way, we can definitely help our children. So only thing is that we should not allow them to proceed, increase the time limit. That will create an addiction in the child. So we have to stick to the time limits. Okay.
Dr. Simi, there is one more question that is very important in terms of the training aspect of the parents, because we do have many parents who are not well familiarized with the mobile phone, internet options and all. It's fine, the e-learning and all is okay with parent group who have a little bit of knowledge about this thing. Now, what about the group of parents where the internet knowledge or connectivity is a bit low? How do you think we can reach them?
I was just answering this question only. So I would like to say that if the internet connectivity is very poor and if it is not able, they are not able to get access to it. So I think telephones will be again a very good mode of connectivity. But we have also used this method also, talking to the parents over the telephone, making them understand, like we do in the task analysis, we write down small bits and every minutest details. So like the same way we talk to the parents, first we try to make them understand what we are supposed to do and how we are supposed to do, and then we give them the task analysis one after the other, so that the parent, he is responding with a positive yes or no, or if he is unable to understand, so we will repeat the question. So telephone will be, because telephone connectivity has become very good into the remotest areas also. So through telephones also, we will be able to render education to the children staying at home. So we have done this also in Akanksha, in the remote areas also. We have utilized the services of telephone, and the parents also responded really very well. So I don't think so. Learning ke liye, there is no obstacles. Anything which is, if one path is closed, so we can take another path and help the parents to learn. So if a connectivity is not there, but telephone is there, so we can use the telephone mode and teach the parents at home. And secondly, if the parents are unable to understand the concepts of e-learning, so nowadays the siblings have become much more equipped with the e-learning strategies, because they are also sitting at home and doing their work. So siblings will be able to help the parents. And this is what exactly we have seen in our lockdown period. The siblings have helped the children with special needs, and siblings have helped the parents also to learn the concepts, and they have also helped to learn the parents to utilize the internet facility, how to browse and how to enter and what to do. See, even this webinars, we were not familiar with, but we have gradually learned it. So even when given an opportunity, if the parents are inclined towards learning, or if the parents are interested to learn, they will definitely learn. So the credit will be the parents' interest and their inclination towards that.
I think we have one more participant who would like to ask you a question directly. Yes, dear participant, your mic has been unmuted. You can ask the question directly with the presenter. Can you hear us?
Mohammed Hussain.
Yeah, Mohammed Hussain, your mic has been unmuted. You can ask your question directly with the presenter.
Hello.
Yes, boliye Mohammed Hussain ji, bataiye.
Hello.
Haan, bataiye Mohammed Hussain ji.
Haan, boliye.
Main online aa chuka, dikh raha hu kya main aapko? सिमी मैम,
आपकी आवाज सुनाई दे रही है, मुझे बताइए.
अच्छा, नहीं सर आए क्या ऑनलाइन? उनका प्रेजेंटेशन अलग था.
हेलो
हेमंत जी,
participants, I'm glad to announce that our other two presenters are connected with us. Please bear with us for another few minutes. I think we'll be able to start our next technical session with the other speakers. And meanwhile, I would like to reconfirm what Dr. Simi has said, that learning knows no bounds. This is absolutely true. And as teachers, special educators, I think we are the one to believe this particular phrase, that whatever matters, whether there is a mobile phone or not, whether there is an internet connectivity or not, whatever it is, I think learning can happen in all situations, and we have to explore various avenues and various methods. And what Dr. Simi has said is quite true, that involvement of siblings in the learning process of our children with intellectual and other developmental disabilities plays a very critical role. So I would encourage all our participants today who are attending the webinar, that I'm pretty sure you must have been involving them, but in case you have not explored the option of involving the siblings, please do it. You are going to see wonderful changes happening in the learning aspects of children with special needs. I think Rahul, can we have the presentation of the presenter now that they are connected?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, if you can share the PowerPoint, I think one of the presenters can start.
Yeah, audible?
Yes, I am muting my mic. Over to you, Rajender.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Good afternoon, all. Once again.
Rajender.
Ji, awaaz aa rahi hai meri?
You can start.
Okay, my first slide will be that. Promoting e-learning during COVID-19. Thank you very much. As you all know, COVID-19 pandemic has hit hard not only the economic sector, but has led the educational sector too in Dalma. The decision of having nationwide lockdown was a good move by the government and much appreciated even the WHO, and was much needed in order to save the life of many. Next slide, please. The educational sector too was totally unprepared for this sudden crisis situation due to this pandemic. March onward is a crucial time for both students and teachers, and suddenly all are confined to their houses due to the lockdown. In this situation, anxiety mounts in the minds of students and teachers as to how do we carry out teaching, learning and evaluation. Next, please. E-learn from home. We all, two speakers have been discussing about Moodle. This is one kind of technique or e-learning platform. Is Moodle is an acronym of Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. It is a free and open source learning and management system which enables you to create a private learning space online full of engaging activities and materials. Moodle is used for blended learning, distance education, flipped classroom, and other e-learning projects in schools, colleges, universities, workplaces, and other sectors. Next, please. The other option available is Google Classroom. As we speaker were speaking, Google Classroom is a free web service developed by Google for schools and colleges that aims to simplify creating, distributing, and grading assignments in paperless way. This primary purpose of Google Classroom is to streamline the process of sharing files between teachers and students. Next, please. So we can use the Google Classroom. Next, please. Next. One more slide, please. So we have already taken the time. Next, please. The visual, audio, and kinesthetic learning are the three keys. I'm repeating here. Visual, audio, and kinesthetic learning are three key areas that need to be focused to offer an optimal learning experience. This approach simply means giving opportunities for the students to see the knowledge, hear it and feel it to the core. Next, please. Teachers can even experiment with option of internet chat and internet video conferencing. Online video conferencing systems such as Zoom, Hangout Meet, Skype, GoToMeeting, etc. You are tech savvy, try these two. I have already given the example bottom. The symbol of that e-learning platform like Zoom, Google Hangouts, Skype, GoToMeeting. Next, please. Zoho Meeting, Cisco WebEx Meeting, yeah, next please. These are the, some of the e-platform where we can. So when we talk about during lockdown period, national initiative, main kuch Hindi mein bhi bolna chahunga because I love to speak in Hindi also. Some of the already speakers has already discussed. Swang ek aisa platform hai jahan pe free online courses jo aapko free mukt mein di jati hai learner ke liye adhigam ke liye karne walon ko school level pe महाविद्यालय लेवल पे विश्वविद्यालय लेवल पे जिसको हम स्वैंग बोलते हैं इज अ नेशनल इनिशिएटिव. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. ओके. देयर आर सेवरल आईसीटी इनिशिएटिव ऑफ एमएचआरडी मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय द्वारा और यूनिवर्सिटी ग्रांट कमीशन विश्वविद्यालय अनुदान आयोग द्वारा इंटर यूनिवर्सिटी सेंटर्स IUC जिसके लिए इंफॉर्मेशन एंड लाइब्रेरी नेटवर्क एंड कंसोर्टियम ऑफ एजुकेशनल कम्युनिकेशन जिनका मैंने यहाँ पे लिंक भी दिया है सिंबल दिया है इन्फ्लिनेट सेंटर सूचना एवं पुस्तकालय नेटवर्क केंद्र ऑनलाइन लर्निंग वेबसाइट लाइक MHRD आल्सो गिव फ्री ड्यूरिंग द कोरोना वायरस लॉकडाउन फॉर UG PG स्वयं प्रभा यूट्यूब चैनल नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी शोध सुधांगना ई शोध सिंधु एंड विद्वान. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. So I am giving the symbolic of this all the tools which are electronic tools. You can see that vertical of SWAM and this is e-Pathshala, SWAM Prabha, Consortium of Educational Communication. Next please. National Digital Library. This is the symbol. जहाँ पे 65 लाख से अधिक किताबों को भी बिल्कुल मुफ्त में इनमें ऐड किया गया है National Digital Library में. Sod Sanga, I will explain otherwise next in the next slide, please. These are the some of the symbol: Diksha, Pathshala, Swayam, Sod Suddhi. These are all are the electronic platform which we have already discussed in our presentation one. I have already discussed. Next, please. How to gauge students' learning? हम किस तरह छात्र के अधिगम को माप सकते हैं? Well, here are some things that you as a teacher can do gauge their learning. On each PowerPoint presentation, lecturer or video or any resource power provided by you give them a set of problem based learning jahan pe unko samasya aati samasya adharit adhigam jo hum prashn dete hain jise bloom taxonomy bhi kehte hain higher order thinking skills and task ask for submission of their answer to you yani hum is tarah ke kuch test kar sakte hain unke adhigam jo unko samasya deti hai unko mapne ke liye through PowerPoint through lecture through video. Next please. Diksha, this is some of the I think participant has asked. This is one kind of app has more than 80,000 e-books for classes 1 to 12. I know most of the participant from the special education disability rehabilitation background. I agree, but this is the overall platform we can we are sharing here from this platform. यहाँ class 1st से लेके class 12 तक के बच्चों के लिए 80,000 से ज़्यादा e-books की व्यवस्था है जिसका website हमने यहाँ पे link किया है. Diksha. .gov.in. Next, please. E-Pathshala. In this web portal of NCERT, has developed 1886 audios. यानी इसको आप सुन सकते हैं 2000 videos, 696 e-books and 504 flip books for classes 1 to 12 in different language website. It will be helpful for the not only for the you know basically the special children with the special needs. Of course, it will be helping to the normal education you know learner also. That is, I have given the website http://epathshala.nic.in. Swang, Swang is also up to class 9, 11th and 12th. That is 1900 course covering both schools and the graduates and postgraduates. That link I have given website. Next please. स्वयं प्रभा. स्वयं प्रभा इज वन काइंड ऑफ एजुकेशनल ई प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर 32 DTH TV due to home television channel transmitting contents on 24/7 यानी सातों दिन 24 घंटे ये वेबसाइट काम करती है जिसमें कि इसमें कंटेंट दिया है इनके 32 चैनल है. अदर आईसीटी इनिशिएटिव्स लाइक या प्लीज नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट ओके लाइक फॉसी व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशनड दैट इज अ रोबोटिक एजुकेशन ई यंत्रा फॉसी वर्चुअल एक्सपेरिमेंट वर्चुअल लैब्स एंड लर्निंग प्रोग्राम स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल्स आर ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन वेरी large access rate. Next please. Now this is a very major point, advantages of e-learning. We have already discussed, our two speakers has also spoke about this. Hame kya fayda hota hai e-learning ka? Now we will talk overall with the special needs children, divyangjan chhatra as well as normal kids, right? You are able to link the various resources in various formats. Aap is platform ko विभिन्न तरह के संसाधनों का इस्तेमाल करते हुए उन बच्चों को फायदा दे सकते हैं. दूसरा, इट इज वेरी एफिशिएंट वे ऑफ डिलीवरिंग कोर्सेज ऑनलाइन. ऑफ कोर्स इट विल बी मोर हेल्पिंग टू द यो लर्नर. ड्यू टू दिस इट्स कन्वीनियंस एंड फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी द रिसोर्सेज आर अवेलेबल फ्रॉम एनीवेयर एंड एट एनी टाइम. जरूरी नहीं है कि क्लास में आए, हम कहीं से बैठ के, जैसे आज हम ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म पे वेबिनार कर रहे हैं, तो सम ऑफ द टेक्निकल थिंग आई विल ऑल्सो टॉक. बट ऑफकोर्स इज वेरी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, इसमें लचीलापन होता है, आदमी से आराम से हम सीख सकते हैं इसमें. नेक्स्ट वन, एवरी वन हू आर पार्ट टाइम स्टूडेंट्स और वर्किंग फुल टाइम कैन टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ वेब बेस्ड लर्निंग. ऑफकोर्स इससे जो पार्ट टाइम जो जॉब में होते हैं उनको भी फायदा हो सकता है. वेब बेस्ड लर्निंग प्रमोट्स एक्टिव एंड इंडिपेंडेंट लर्निंग. ऑफकोर्स ये आपको इतना सजग बनाता है, इतना एम्पावर करता है कि आप अपने खुद से स्वतंत्र से पूर्वा कर सकते हैं. As you have access to net 24/7, yani 24 ghante yadi aap access karte hain net ko, you can train yourself anytime and from anywhere also. Yadi aap access internet ko kar sakte hain, aaram se is cheez ko jo advantage hai e-learning ka istemal kar sakte hain. It is very convenient and flexible option. Above all, you don't have to depend on anyone for anything. Yeah, of course, this is very major line I have mentioned. पर डिपेंडेंट आश्रित होने की जरूरत नहीं है, हम खुद से इस जो जितने प्लेटफॉर्म है प्लेटफॉर्म का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. नेक्स्ट प्लीज द लास्ट स्लाइड. डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ ई लर्निंग, मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑनलाइन असेसमेंट्स आर लिमिटेड टू क्वेश्चन दैट आर ओनली ऑब्जेक्टिव इन नेचर. सर जितनी भी प्लेटफॉर्म होती है लर्निंग के इलेक्ट्रॉनिक में, मोस्टली क्या होता है, कहीं कहीं लिमिटेशन डिलिमिटेशन की बात हम करते हैं, तो ये प्रॉब्लम होती है इस डिसएडवांटेज में है. देयर इज आल्सो द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द एक्सटेंट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी ऑफ ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. या ऑफ कोर्स सिक्योरिटी सुरक्षा की दृष्टि से इट इज नॉट, वी कैन से दैट सम ऑफ द ऐप आर वेरी गुड, सम ऑफ द ऐप आर लाइक वी वर डिस्कसिंग अर्लियर व्हेन वी हैव स्टार्टेड हियर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर डिप्लोमा लेवल स्टूडेंट्स इन सीआरसी राजनांदगांव. So we have seen that some Zoom app is not safer. So after a few days, we have started with Cisco WebEx meeting and we are taking from that. So you have to be very careful while starting the electronic platform, which app is very safer. The authenticity of a particular student's work is also a problem, as online just about anyone can do a project rather than an actual student itself. Is very disadvantage, one kind of disadvantage for the students level. The assessments that are computer marked generally have a tendency of being only knowledge based, not necessarily particularly based. Yeah, कभी कभी हमें क्या होता है, जब हम किसी का आकलन करते हैं कंप्यूटर बेस्ड मार्क्स में, तो हो सकता है कि मे बी सम ऑफ द एरर कैन बी टेकन प्लेस ड्यूरिंग द दिस प्लेटफॉर्म. थैंक यू. नेक्स्ट इफ इट इज. थैंक यू वेरी मच संदीप. या ऑफकोर्स COVID-19 pandemic is an unprecedented situation and no one can really know how long it will be. Hame pata nahi aur kitne mahine hame inse guzarna hai, inke sath chalna hai. Before normal routine life begins for us, yes of course, hamara samanya jeevan kab se shuru hoga, we don't know as a teacher, professors, participants, learners, educators. Social distancing will be go a long way in controlling the situation. Of course, what we are talking about, डिस्टेंसिंग बना के मास्क पहन के ऑफकोर्स इसको रखना है और अपना जो कड़े है ऑनलाइन के प्लेटफॉर्म के माध्यम से वो पूरा करना है. दिस इज अ टाइम फॉर ऑल द टीचर्स टू अनलीश देयर innovative side and come up with ways to continue teaching. Learning and assessment by online means we need to come up with a positive plan to start the learning from home, learning journey of our students, of course. In a safer mode, we can say that हमें learning तो करना है और learning के साथ साथ हमें अपनी safety का ध्यान रखना है, स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा का ध्यान रखना है. Thank you very much. Thank you,
Rajendra, for a very nice and crisp presentation. Participants definitely must have understood what are the various e-learning options which are available, like MOOCs, the Swayam, and all. I'm sure they are going to explore after this webinar these particular sites on what are the various learning modules which are available for both students and faculty also. And now we have our next presenter, Dr. Hemant, with us. I would request Rahul to connect us with Dr. Hemant if he is there. Otherwise, we can take few questions. Yes, we are having Dr. Hemant with us. We are very shortly going to start the presentation. Over to Dr. Hemant now.
Yeah, thanks, Shilpa, and I seriously apologize for the interruption, and that the part and parcel of e-learning, I should say, negative aspect. But yes, we need to still enhance ourselves, develop our platform, the technology, so that we can be in a better position to promote e-learning. But yes, as of now, we can. We still have gone long way, and we need to develop our infrastructure here. The current slide tells us about various e-sources platforms which have been discussed earlier also, and some of the slides are on various packages, e-learning packages for children with autism, and e-learning games for children with intellectual disabilities. Yeah, next slide. In this next slide, I am discussing on virtual classroom. What are the requirements for having a virtual classroom? Ensuring the parents and teachers having access to internet and backup power, because this is very important. If you don't have a good access or internet facility and power backup, then electricity is also a problem, and internet is also becomes a problem. Then it is a virtual kind of classroom cannot function. Then parents and teachers must have access to laptops, PC, or smartphones with minimum 5-inch screen display should be there. Preferably, children must use laptop or PCs. Download Skype, WhatsApp, MOOC, or on computer or phone. Make small groups of children based on the age and severity as per the norms or prescribed by various disabilities or severities. Then pre-plan individual and group activity plan so that the teachers can take the lessons in a better way. This planning is definitely different from the usual face-to-face IEP planning or group activity planning, because here you need to develop a proper lesson plan which includes audio-visual material as well as various kinds of other e-resources also. So the teacher needs to be well trained in e-learning. He or she should be well-trained e-learning teacher. So the computer as well as other PowerPoint presentation she should be good at. Then what is the difference? Generally, we then overlap with virtual classroom and video conferencing. So I would like to have a presentation on this. Virtual classroom, video conferencing platform like our WhatsApp and Skype, and virtual classroom platform are Swayam, MOOCs, Zoho, Google Meet, etc. other platforms. then very Google video conferencing is very generic application of communication purpose, for communication purpose, whereas virtual classroom are specifically designed to build to provide classrooms classroom experiences on virtual platform. Video conferencing does not have ability to define and organize contents per pedagogy or curriculum and learning outcomes, whereas virtual classroom pedagogy or curriculum and learning outcomes can be defined and organized for systematic learning. Provision for a repository to store and share documents and knowledge points during the course of learning, whereas generally which virtual classroom has a repository to store and share documents and knowledge points. Video conferencing does not have assessment and measures to track and monitor the learning outcomes, whereas virtual classroom provides feedback mechanism in the form of measures to track and monitor learning outcomes of and assessment of the learner. Next. Yeah, learning challenges for persons with intellectual disabilities. As we all are aware that persons with intellectual disability do have challenges in memorizing things. They have problems with concentration, poor attention, reading, writing, mathematic abilities, then communication skills, and they have limitations in logical thinking and reasoning. But keeping in view these challenges, how we would be discussing how e-learning can help us in facilitating these children. Let's discuss the barriers. There are four barriers we have. We'll be discussing in the forthcoming slides. That is time barrier, space barrier, analog digital barrier, and norm barrier, and how they can these barriers can resolve the issues. Now the time barrier. E-learning can be used by learners to allot their time to learn when they want to learn, can also travel back and forth in time, making it possible to examine the pace of learning and accordingly make necessary arrangements, necessary accommodations as per the ability or pace of learning of the learner. The next, space barrier. Space barrier. May I request to switch over the slides? Space barrier, next slide. Yeah. In e-learning, learning objects can be distributed all over the world, made accessible to learner via internet. It allows learner to access rare resources and expand their learning space. Then next, analog digital barrier. Digital content offers possibility to combine different media such as video, audio, text, and images. This is the wonder of this e-learning methodology, where we can mix up various videos, audios, text. This not only helps in having an interesting lesson, but also helps in written, motivating the learner to learn the concept and develop a good learning concept on a particular subject. This enables learner to interact with digital content using different media, different digital media for the learner learning process more easily than analog media. This enhances learning and develops interest in amongst persons with intellectual disabilities. So when the teacher develops, they should be well trained in the analog digital things. The norm barrier. Norm barrier can be overcome by e-learning, resulting in growth of learning opportunities for all people. E-learning provides more individualized and personalized learning. For a person with intellectual disability, it can expand the scope of learning opportunities. Accessible content of learning, accessible communication between all learners, and accessible construction of personal as well as shared knowledge can lead to expanded learning opportunities for persons with intellectual disability. Then how technology and e-learning can support each other. Speakable items like speech synthesis, voice recognition, and portable word processor, alternate keyboards, one hand keyboard or little finger keyboards, and mouse alternatives are available like scroll or trackballs and head mouse, touch screen or window screen, touch window screen, screens are there, and word processor software, prediction software, which helps person with disability to for e-learning. Then next slide, yeah, accessible e-learning technology. Principles of accessible content. There are four accessible principles of content: perceivable, operable, understandable, and robust. Next. This we are discussing because any teacher who want to develop e-learning lessons should have these concept in mind so that they can develop good e-learning lessons so that their learners can learn, and at the same time they can evaluate as well as do the assessment periodically. Monitoring becomes easier, learning become more interesting. So all these things should be kept in mind by the teachers who before developing a good e-learning lesson plan. Provide text under perceivable, provide text alternatives for any non-text content. Example, large prints, braille, speech, symbols, or simpler language. Provide synchronized alternative for multimedia. Create content that can be presented in different ways, that is spoken, aloud, or simpler layout, etc. Make it easier for person with intellectual disability to see and hear content, including separating foreground from the background. This is also very important, that how we can differentiate foreground sound or foreground images from the background. Next, operable. This principle make all functionality available from a keyboard, provides users with disabilities enough time to read and use content. Do not create contents that is known to cause seizures. This is I would like that this is very important, as children with intellectual disability have a comorbid condition of seizures, and teachers should take expert advice from the neurologist whether to how much time they can be exposed to screens, because continuous flickering of screens do create seizures. That's what study research says. So particularly children having seizures should be taken special care for e-learning protocols. Then provide ways to help users with disabilities navigate. Understandable, make text content readable and understand. Make web pages appear and operate in predictable ways. Help users to avoid and correct mistakes that do occur. Robust. This principle maximize compatibility and current and future user agents. So there are certain disadvantages which Mr. I would not like to repeat it. I believe Mr. Rajinder has covered most of the things, and this is the references. Yeah, now I wind up my presentation. I would invite questions from the participants, if